Hi students, let us continue our yesterday's topic. We have learned yesterday how do we take the signs of the trigonometric ratios in the quadrants. We have used a statement as like that, all silver teacups. Let us see the continuation. We have to see the continuation as units of measurement of angles. How do we measure the angles? To measure the angles, we have various unit measurements are there. Here, units of measurement of angles. Measurement of angles. The first measurement. Our first system to measure the angle, the first system is sexagesimal measurement or sexagesimal system. Sexagesimal measurement. Measurement. In this measurement, we have to measure the angles in degrees, minutes and seconds. In this system, we measure the angles in degrees, minutes and seconds. Like this. Mostly we use this system to measure the angles. This is a British system. We use this system only. That is Indian. The Indians use this system. This is British system. 1 degree denoted by as like this. One, a small zero. 1 degree. This is denoting as like this. 1 right angle taking as like this. 90 degrees. 1 straight angle taking as 180 degrees. Okay? Also, one more important thing here, in this measurement, 1 degree defined as 60 minutes. This is the 1 dash is denoting as minutes. 1 minute is defined as 60 seconds. These are the measurements of the angles in which system? Sexagesimal system or sexagesimal measurement. Often we use this system, sexagesimal system. The next other system is, the second system is centesimal measurement. That is French system. Sexagesimal system is actually this is a British system. British system. We use this system often. Next. Centesimal system. Centesimal system or measurement. This is nothing but centesimal system, nothing but this is a French system, not our system. Rare cases we have to use this system. French system. Let us see how do we measure the angle in this centesimal system. In centesimal system, we measure the angles in grades. One grade defined as like this. One grade defined as one a small g, write like this. Next, one right angle defined as right angle defined as 100 grades. One straight angle defined as straight angle defined as 200 grades, as like this. One more thing, as one more we can define as like this. One grade equals to 100 minutes. This is denoting as 100 minutes. Okay? One more thing. In this system, 1 minute defined as 100 seconds. 100 seconds. This is centesimal system. One more important system is there to measure the angle as like this, that is circular system. The third one is circular measurement or circular system, that is called often a radian system. Here the third one is circular system. Circular. In this system, we measure the angle in radians. This is radian system. This is universal system. We can define as like this. One radian denoting as one right small c. This is 1 radian. Pi radians can be taken as 180 degrees. This is the relation between radians and degrees. Listen. Here one more important thing. A note condition is there. As like this. 1 degree equals to pi by 180 radians. Listen. To convert the degrees into radians, wherever 1 degree is there, that is multiplying with pi by 180. So, that angle should be converted into radians. If radians converted to degrees, wherever pi is there, you have to take 180 degrees. Let us see one more important note condition is there. There is a relation between degrees, grades and radians as like this. One more note condition as like this. 180 degrees, nothing but one straight angle. 200 grades, this is a straight angle. Pi, this is a straight angle in radians. Pi nothing but how many degrees? 180 degrees. 180 is straight angle in degrees. 200 is straight angle in grades. Pi is straight angle in radians. All equal here. This is the relation between degrees, grades and radians. This equality is useful to convert the angles, grades into degrees, degrees into radians, radians into grades, radians into degrees, as like this. This relation is very useful to convert the angles into one measurement to another measurement. Let us see the problems. How do we convert the degrees into radians? Let us going to see. We have to do some problems of like this. Convert the following degrees into radians. Problem. Convert the following degrees into radians. Convert the following degrees into radians. Degrees into radians. It means radian measurement. Let us see very first problem. 30 degrees. We are going to convert the 30 degrees into radians. Let us see how do we convert them. This can be written as 30 into 1 degree. I already told you how do we take 1 degree. Pi by 180 radians. 30 into pi by 180 degrees. Okay. 180 radians. Now this is radian measurement. What are get cancelled? Zero. What are 3 6 are 5 by 6 radians. Okay. Simply we can write without using C also. No problem. This is 5 by 6 radians equal to 30 degrees. We are continuing the remaining problems in the next class.